All right, I'm just going out to feed the chickens and to feed our horse Jazz. So off I go. Chick, chick, chicks! Are they in there? Okay. You stay there so that they come for Grandma, okay? Because otherwise they might run. All right, I just got done doing an unboxing of, this is the low braided pony in Caramel Kiss. I love it. It's so gorgeous. This might be the one going to my nephew's wedding. 2 weeks. I have 2 weeks until the wedding. All right, I'm gonna turn my camera around so you guys can see the chicks. Hi, chick chicks. Hi, son. Hi, son. How are you doing? I'm sorry, my big shadow is in here. Do you guys remember Son from Colton's video? Hi, son. Hi, sweetie. She was the feather foot. All right. Let's get you guys some food, huh? Are you hungry? Are you babies hungry? All right, I put some strawberries in here too. I'm gonna show you guys. They'll fight over them. They start to chase each other for the strawberries. Oh, yep, there he's got one. Look. Let's see, I'll throw a few more out. Strawberry, there you go, son. They love the berries, raspberries too. All right, I'll get you some food. Hey, yo. There we go. Aren't they cute? So these are the babies, and we just have put them outside now, and we still need to get a roof. We don't have a roof on the kennel yet. If you see that doghouse in the distance, tomorrow we are going to work on putting nesting boxes on the side of that so that we can start gathering eggs when these babes start laying their eggs. So they are totally free range, but I feed them in here because eventually when we get the roof on and we put the dog kennel up to it, I want to make sure that they're in at night and safe. So, but right now they've been doing just fine. Are the crows? Do you hear the crows? They want that chicken food. All right, I'm gonna go feed Jazz. So Jazz is pawing for her food. Hi, Jazzercise. So we call it the pretty dance. When she knows that she's gonna get her grain, she puts one leg up. And Jazz is 26 years old. This is something that she has done. And since we have owned her, we've had her since she was 11. She has won everything for my daughters, from saddles to bridles to halters. She's mad. but now she's retired now. She's been great. My daughters did high school rodeo with her and WSCA, which is Western Saddle Club, and won tons of trophies, tons of ribbons, just had so much fun. I drove the truck and trailer, believe it or not, and then I would braid her mane. Her mane came off this winter because we had a winter blanket on her neck. Here you go, Jazzy. And, but she used to have the most long, beautiful mane. There goes Colten on a four-wheeler. Jazzercise. She's so pretty. She's a red dun. I love her tail. There he goes. The madman. All right, so you guys wanted to see some animals being fed. I am going to throw Jazz some hay and that will be it, and then I'll feed the kittens in the garage, but you've already seen the kittens. Here he comes. Scares the living daylights out of this grandma. So we've been doing a bunch of landscaping. So in here, we actually have a culvert over here. And then that goes, hey sweetheart, underneath Jazz's pasture. And then there's a pond on the other side of those trees. So this is also sort of a holding pond. If we would have a bunch of water, there is a ditch back there, and that is hundreds upon hundreds of acres of field behind us. We don't really have a woods, just a few trees. So Colton's dad has been helping us with this, so the water can come through here and then pool in here if we have too much water. But we've been in kind of a drought. But now Colton and I, what did we decide that we wanted to do here?
To make a swimming pool.
Yeah, we thought it would be really fun to have our own swimming hole. And so I don't know if we can talk Papa into that. Colton's riding his little Forzinger. It's a little Yamaha really Forzinger. It is. Don't go too fast now, you scare Grandma.
Hey, it's fun. I drift in the winter on the snow.
Yeah, that's no.
But as long as you don't stop when you do it.
Well, don't do it in the gravel, honey, because if you flip it, you'll scare the living daylights out of me.
I know.
But you can see, so it is a 50cc. It's a little Yamaha Forzinger.
They're really rare now.
Yeah, if any of you motorheads, so this is an old one. I think it's probably from the 80s.
I'm probably going to sell it when I get older.
No, you can't. So we bought it for Colton, and then our nephew actually refurbished it and got the new stickers and polished her up. And then the rewind was broke, so they just got it fixed, right?
Yeah. This broke the throttle cable, and then the
so there's the chickens over there.
But now I have my old four-wheeler at that dad's place, and he's putting the pitch deck on it.
There's my husband. I don't know what he's doing now. He's always doing something, but he's got to go to work here at about 8 o'clock.
And he also, also putting my muffler back on.
Okay, so here's the two older chicks, Colton. Let's show them the two older chicks. So these hens were from last year. These were last year's Easter presents. They've been doing good, haven't you? It's always loud around here, you guys. Oh, Colton, we gotta show them our strawberry patch. Oh, there's Jazz's bucket. You wanna pick up the bucket? So this is our strawberry patch. So my husband got me the planter for Mother's Day.
There's two of them right here that are starting to get ready.
Oh, here, look, Grandma, come in and see.
There's two of them right here that are starting to get ready.
Oh, yeah, so these are the ever-bearing strawberries that we have. And Craig got me these, this pretty planter. So it's kind of nice, it's right underneath the window in the barn. Maybe I'm zoomed in, here we go. So our strawberries are doing good. We've been watering it, huh? Yeah, I'll show them how you start your Forzinger. You want to start your Forzinger? Okay, Colton wants to show you how he starts his Forzinger. Just wait, let me get over here, sweetie.
I mean, it doesn't have reverse, so I have to push it back.
Oh, okay. You push it back then. All right, you go ahead and start it, sweetie. There goes Papa.
I have to put it all the way
You have to do what?
Here on the off right now.
Okay.
So I mean, this is the run. So I have to put all the way back and that's a start. And then, I mean, the choke is, like this choke right here, is just for like it's when it's winter time and it doesn't want to start even though it's like on start or it's on run.
Okay.
And then, but like right now, but like if you leave it sit for like a night, it will cool down the engine. So you have to, sometimes if like you leave it for a while at night, you'll have to give it some throttle when you...
Okay.
But since it's warmed up now, since I've been...
You don't need to choke it now? Okay. Wow, that started up perfect. All right, you be careful now. Watch where you're going. All right. Love you. Horse trailer that I used to drive. Well, I used to drive the truck, pull the trailer. So here's all of our hay. So my husband cuts and bales all the hay off of our field, and then also my sister-in-law has about 10 acres and they live about 4 miles away. So he cuts and bales that as well. So I am gonna get some hay here and go feed Jazz the hay. The scissors are to cut the twine. So I just threw Jazz her hay, and I really should have thought about that before I wore this brand new beautiful wig. I'd probably get hay in here, but there she's eating her hay. I don't think she's gonna come up for air. She loves her food. Alright, so I hope that you guys enjoyed that little look at farm life here in Minnesota. It's Friday night, and I love this caramel kiss, double braided up to, down in all its glory. Beautiful color. Alright, have a great weekend, everyone. I'll see you later. Hi, son.